Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see how to generate random test data using JavaFaker library. What is test data? Data which is required to test an application is called as a test data. And we have wide varieties of test data like person details, employee has a different set of data, customer has a different set of test data, and so on. As we have different regions, we have different locales as well. And if this application is going to support different locales, we need test data on it as well. And to simulate the customer use case, we need huge volumes of test data. So these are all the requirements of test data, and it would be of helpful if we have one library which actually suffices all these requirements, right? And one such library is JavaFaker library. It generates dummy data, which looks like real-time data. And this library supports more than 35 domains like finance, food, books, name, address, and business, and so on. And the library also supports different locales like German, French, English, Australia, English, US, and so on. And we can check this link to actually verify the available domains and all the locales it supports. Let's navigate to this URL. And we can see this is a GitHub. So we can find the source code of the library here and slowly scroll on here. And you can see a dependency here. If you are using a Maven project, you just need to add this dependency to your project. And that's it. You can just go ahead and use the JavaFaker class and its methods. If you're using Gradle as build tool, then you can just add this dependency to your project. So we have a demo web application as well. So let's see this now. You can see some data here, right? First name, last name, street name, second address, street address, and so on. So if I refresh this page, the data is changed and we get another set of random data here. Whenever we refresh this page, we are getting random test data. So this web application was developed using the JavaFaker library. And we also have the clear documentation on this JavaFaker. So you can see here, this library has 4 packages and the different classes available are listed here, like address, ancient, app, and so on, right? For example, let's click on address class. We can see the different methods this class has, like address has building number, city, city name. We just need to know which class to use and which method to use for according to our requirement. Now let's go back and you can see the domains, address, ancient, animal, and so on. We have like many domains here. So these are the different classes we can see, which we can use it to generate different types of test data. And we have different locales. You can see the supported locales here. These are the list of locales supported. Right, now let's see an example. I have already added the dependency to my pom.xml. This is my Maven project. And now I can actually create an object of the Faker class. Let me create the object of the Faker class. And using this object, we can actually generate the test data. So let's import this Faker class from the com.github.javafaker. And then we can use the Faker object now. So name is one class. In this, we have different methods. So I wanted to display random first names. So let's have this printed on the console. And you can see here a random data Trista, right? So whenever I execute it again, so we get another set of random data, right? So different on different runs, we get different data. Now let's see some more methods here. I can have first name and this and have it here. This is my first name. And we have last name, which is also present in the name class. We can use last name method to get the different random last names. And let's have some phone number. And for that, we need to use the phone number class. In that, I'm going to use the phone number method. And let's have address. We can use address class. And we can go to the level of building number, random building number, city, city's names, country, and so on, right? I'm going to use full address method, which actually gives us the full address. These are the different examples of test data. Now let's display this on the console. First name, last name, and we have phone number, right? So let's also display phone number as well. And then we'll have address. I'm just having some space here so that we have the clear visibility when the data is displayed. And we'll also have some we'll run this all this 10 times so that we can see more randomness. I'm going to have 10 rows of test data. Right? Now let me execute this method, this program. And you can see we have different test data, right? So you can see different first names, different last names, phone numbers, and different address. And if you observe, all this data belongs to the locale US, English US. So we didn't specify any locale. The default locale is English US. And we can have different locales as well by specifying new locale. And let me give it as India. And we just need to import this locale class from Java util package and just execute this same program. And you can see a different set of test data here, which are related to the, which are related to country India. You can see here, these are the first names and last names, which are related to India. And even you can see the format of phone number as well. And the address also changes if you observe. These are all the set of test data, which are related to India. And this is how we can set the different locales by passing an argument to the Faker class while creating an object. And one can actually use like generate the test data and write it to some file, or can push it to the database and wherever we want, right? According to the requirement, according to our requirement. So in this video, we discuss like how to generate random test data using JavaFaker library, a small library, but a powerful library to generate the test data. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.